I love Quantrix and I want to make you a Quantrix master. Go to QuantrixAuthority.com to learn more.
Hey, welcome back to another NetCast. I'm Rich Lopez, Quantrix Authority. I sincerely appreciate you joining me today for episode number 275, where I'm going to show you how to return multiple fields using a select statement. I absolutely love Quantrix. I think it is an awesome tool. It makes my day every day that I get to use it. And one of the reasons why is because you can do cool stuff like I'm about to show you. I have here a model. And what I have a couple fields. I have a facility for add use that has some values in it from time to time. And then I have this machine count use that has numbers in it that indicate when I have a facility that has a new item in it. And then I have this type of machine that is being added to the facility. And what I would like to do in this P machine summary matrix is I would like to go ahead and I would like to summarize, or I'd like to bring back all the instances of the facility and the machine where I have a machine count use greater than one. So I want to bring back this field and this field together when this value is greater than, I guess, greater than zero. I think I said greater than one before, but it's really greater than zero. How do I do that? Well, it's very simple in Quantrix. I would write a formula and I would simply say in auto machine type machine and facility type, and I'll click on it, and then I don't have to type that all the way out because it's got a special character, and it equals, I want to do a select statement first. And actually I want to do a select statement because this is going to be conditional, and my condition is greater than zero here where machine count use is greater than zero. But what do I want to bring back? Well, I want to bring back my machine type use that I'm on, and I want to bring back this facility for add use. And how I join or bring back two different fields is I simply go out and I say and I'm going to put some separator out there, and I'm going to use my favorite separator, which is a bar or a pipe. And then I'm going to put another and the other field I want to bring back is this facility for add use. All right, my key list, and now it's just like or my test range, it's just like a normal select S. My test range is anything with a machine count use here, and I want to have it have the criteria of greater than zero. And I'm going to go ahead and close my select. What happens is it brings back an instance of that, and if I were to go ahead and look at my dependency inspector, I could look and see that indeed it's actually bringing back a list of items, because that is what your select statement does. And it's bringing back two items. So how can I see both of these items of machine default H1 and machine default of H1? Because again, I should see that here. And how you can do that is you can simply write a join statement here. And you've seen that before on the Quantrix Authority. And a join just joins my list with some sort of separator. And my list and my separator is going to be a comma. So I'm going to put a comma and a char 10, and what a char 10 does is it simply makes it so that there's a line break in my formula or in my result set. So I have here now the list of those items that it's going to bring back for this specific year, and this year is 2020. I'm looking at, and there's going to be a machine default of H1, and it is going to come in two times. Because in the year 2020, right here, you can see this 2020, I have an instance that's greater than one here, and I have an instance that's greater than one also here. If I were to go out here and put in, say, a value here, say I put in a 3, then I would expect to see that actually populate as an H1 due to some other formulas I have going on in this model, but then I would expect to see this H1, another machine, showing up in here, and indeed, that is what is happening. So how do you bring back multiple fields with a select or a select S statement? You can just go ahead and you can concatenate them here in Quantrix Modeler. and it will bring them back. I just think that is totally rad that you can do that. I hope you found that enlightening and exciting. I want you to know that I love Quantrix. I really do want to make you a Quantrix master. And I hope that you'll reach out to me at quantrixauthority@gmail.com with any question you have about Quantrix. It is a free service, and I will try to answer your question here on the podcast. And please join me again for another episode of Quantrix Authority with Rich Lopez.
Today's podcast is brought to you by QuantrixAuthority.com. I love Quantrix, and I want to make you a Quantrix master.